which once served as a refuge for Jews fleeing anti-Semitism in other European nations, but whose Jewish community finds itself now increasingly under assault. Well, joining us for more is Rabbi Binyamin Jacobs, the Dutch chief rabbi, the chief rabbi of the Netherlands, joining us from the city of Amersfoort. And Rabbi Jacobs, thank you for joining us. Some, I have to say, disturbing reports this week, citing you, quoting you, expressing concern that the battle against anti-Semitism in Europe may be lost even. It may be too late even for the Jewish communities there to turn the tide back. Give us a sense of the situation as you see it in the Netherlands and across Europe.
Situation at this very moment, let's say we should know that anti-Semitism and anti-Zionism is exactly the same. I'm Jewish and therefore I'm a Zionist. That is, everybody knows that today. So if I give a speech somewhere, then I get the compliment that my Dutch is so good and so well. So I said, but I'm Dutch. Oh, we thought you were Jewish. We see there's a ceasefire in Israel, but anti-Semitism continues. In 2014, it stopped more or less after the ceasefire. Now it continues. And it is getting stronger and stronger everywhere, in the whole of Europe. In front of my daughter's house, she lives in London, there were cars demanding, calling upon the public to rape Jewish girls in the street, public. Last week, I was, Free Palestine. Today, a university, an official Dutch university, had the whole slogan that Palestine should be free from one side till the sea. So it removed it. But we see everywhere it getting stronger and stronger, especially universities. But this gives you, if I may correct you, yes. In Holland, before the war, there was Jews were integrated. There was no anti-Semitism visible. But we should remind, we shouldn't forget that 80% of Dutch Jewry was killed in the war, in the Shoah. And it was the Dutch police who took the Jews from the houses. And there were no Muslims yet in Holland. So anti-Semitism is changing is like a virus. Corona will finish, but the virus, anti-Semitism, will continue with different mutations. And today, the mutation is anti-Zionism. We see it was now in government, so forming a new government, like in Israel. And there was a fight, not about the tax in Holland, or about other issues, the climate in Holland. No, about Israel.
Right, Robert Jacobs, my comment about the Netherlands as a refuge for Jews was going back a few centuries, I should clarify.
That's true.
But that does raise the question, where are the authorities? Where are the governments of Europe? What aren't they doing? Yeah. What should they be doing about this situation?
Exactly, where are they? I don't know. We don't hear anything. Of course, to me personally, they're friendly. I get protection. Our schools, and there are two Jewish schools, they get protected. Soldiers in front of the school. But that's it. Police is fine. Official government is okay. But more and more, the demonstrations in Holland against Israel, the pro-Gaza demonstrations, this was not just pro-Gaza, anti-Israel, it was anti-Semitic. And people from government joined, and it was accepted. A few words about it, it's not nice, blah, 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 but they were there. When there was one demonstration pro-Israel, nobody spoke against Arabs or anything. Everybody was asking, please give us freedom for everybody. Everybody wants to live in peace, but them is anti-Jewish. And government does not do enough about it. Yes, they do protect us. That's true, but that's about it. In politics, it is a very dangerous situation.
Right.
And I think it's getting worse and worse and worse. And what I'm warning is like this. I'm not going to leave Europe meanwhile. I'm here.
But I want to ask you about that, Rabbi Jacobs, because going back and looking at some past articles, I saw one from a little over a decade ago in which you were saying Jews should not panic and be leaving Europe. More recent articles have you saying they should go, but you feel a responsibility to stay there and do your job. But if you didn't have that role, you would join those that you were advising to leave Europe.
I'm very doubtful what to say, yes or no. If I say openly leave Holland, then they will say, you see, you don't belong in Europe, and I don't think that's right to think like that. On the other hand, we have to be realistic. Before the Second World War, how come so many Jews were killed? The highest percentage from the whole of Europe to Holland. Why? Because the most people thought, the Germans against the German Jews and against the Polish Jews, but not against, we're Dutch. I want to wake up Dutch Jewry and warn them. Don't fall asleep. Don't put your head in the sand and think nothing is happening. There is an increasing anti-Semitic approach in Holland and in the whole of Europe. So the political leaders, and there are, but they're not the majority, are seeing this, are recognizing this. And officials are against it. But on the other hand, they tolerate demonstrations, anti-Semitic demonstrations. I'll just give you an example. I haven't been in a train or any public transport for more than 10 years because police advised me not to go in a train. My house is surrounded by cameras. It's very nice they're doing it, but it is most ridiculous. Most ridiculous. And that's the situation. So, yes, I hope European Jewish life could continue, but we also have to be a little bit realistic. So I'm constantly in a doubt. Should or shouldn't we leave? And, yes, I do advise people to ask me to go to Israel for more reasons. But on the other hand, towards the government, I'm Dutch, more than 10 generations. Yeah, I have the right to stay here. I decide when I leave. And it should not be decided because I'm scared for terrorism, for Hamas and other groups. There's a whole BDS here, movement here, which are very, very influential, very strong. People listening to them. You know, not far away from me, there is the organization called Christian for Israel. They import all kind of products from Israel, and a huge amount of wine. And they have to write on it from the occupied territories. If you don't, you know, the government can come in like Gestapo, and they got a fine because it's not written. They wrote on it, product from Israel, product from Judah and Samaria, but no, from the occupied territories they have to write. It's most ridiculous. Yeah, there are so many other countries in the world with problems. 100 times bigger problems in Israel, in China, in Sahara, etc., etc. Everybody's concentrated on Israel. The government, making a new government, there's no fights about how should we act towards China or to Sahara in from Morocco or other occupied territories. We'll only speak with Israel. And Israel is Jews, that they don't know the difference. And there is not a difference too much. But on the other hand, yes, I always say, you're allowed to be against the politics of Israel. Why not? Yeah, 50% of Israel is against the politics from Netanyahu. But that doesn't mean you're allowed to say right. The Jews should be killed and call upon the world, Muslims. The Muslim leaders are calling upon the people to fight and hit Jews in the whole world.
Right.
And the Semitism and anti-Zionism is exactly the same.
All right. Well, I have to say, Rabbi Jacobs, I have a strong personal connection to Holland through my wife, and this is certainly very disturbing to hear. And certainly we wish all you and all of the Dutch Jewish community there the very best. Dank je wel for joining us on I-24 News.
Graag gedaan in Dutch. It's a pleasure.